Welcome students to another lecture in the series The Merchant of Venice. I am Dr. Sarika Gupta, Assistant Professor Kanya Mahavidyalaya Kharkhoda. Yesterday we studied that Antonio appears very sad. To this Salerio says, My wind cooling my breath would blow me to an ague when I thought what harm a wind too great might do at sea. I should not see the sandy hourglass run, but I should think of shallows and of flats, and see my wealthy Andrews docked in sand, veiling her high top lower than her ribs to kiss her burial. Means, whenever Salerio would cool his soup with his breath, he would be reminded of the great winds that might do harm to his ships on the ocean, and he would not be able to see the sandy hourglass because it would have made him thought about shallow waters and the sandy lands, and when he would be reminded of his ship Andrew lowering her ribs, that is the size of the wooden ship. He imagines that his ships are burying themselves in sands, in sandy grounds. Salerio further says, Should I go to church and see the holy edifice of stone and not bethink me straight of dangerous rocks which touching but my gentle vessel's side would scatter all her spices on the stream and robe the roaring waters with my silks and in a word but even now worth this and now worth nothing. Salerio means to say that the holy edifice of stone of the church would remind him of the dangerous rocks at sea, and what harm would it do to the rocks? The rocks would touch his gentle vessel's side, meaning the ship or the containers in it, and scatter all the cargo clothing the sea with the silk. When his cargo is safe, he has everything, but a misfortune can reduce his happiness in seconds. He is certain that Antonio is sad to think upon his ventures. He goes on to say, Shall I have the thought to think on this? And shall I lack the thought that such a thing be chanced would make me sad? But tell not me, I know Antonio is sad to think upon his merchandise. He says, If he had the imagination to think that such misfortune could fall on him, the thought would make him sad. And he says that he is sure that Antonio is sad because of his merchandise. To this Antonio replies, Believe me, no. I thank my fortune for it. My ventures are not in one bottom trusted, nor to one place. Nor is my whole estate upon the fortune of this present year. Therefore, my merchandise makes me not sad. Antonio rejects this idea. He says, His ventures are not invested in one particular world. So even if one undergoes a misfortune, his other investments would help him to retain his position. Thank you, students. We'll meet tomorrow for another lecture.